Hi parents, Teacher Hajar here to talk about seizure disorders and epilepsy. Okay, what is epilepsy in children? So, epilepsy in children is a brain condition that causes a child to have seizures. So, it is one of the most common disorders of the nervous system. It affects children and adults of all races and ethnic background. The brain consists of nerve cells that communicate with each other through electrical activity. A seizure occurs when you have a burst of abnormal electrical signal that interrupt normal brain signals. This is categories of epileptic seizures. First is focal seizure and generalized seizure. Okay, focal seizure or partial seizure, when abnormal electrical brain function occurs in one or more areas of one side of the brain. So, before a focal seizure occurs, child may have an aura of sign that seizure is about to occur. It involves feeling of fear, may have visual changes, hearing abnormalities, and change in sense of smell. So, there are two types of focal seizure. First is simple focal seizure. The symptom depend on which area of the brain is affected. If the abnormal electrical brain function is the part of the brain involved with vision, the seizure activity is limited to an isolated muscle group. May only include the fingers or larger muscle in the arm and legs. Child may also have sweating, nausea, or become pale. Child won't lose consciousness in this type of seizure. Second, complex focal seizure often occurs in the area of the brain that controls emotion of memory function. Child will likely lose consciousness. Child may stop being aware of what's going on around. Child may look awake but have variety of unusual behavior like gagging, lip smacking, running, screaming, crying, and laughing. Next, we go to second type of seizure, generalized seizure. First is absence seizure. This seizure causes a brief change state of consciousness and staring. Child will likely maintain posture, mouth office may twitch or eyes may blink rapidly. The seizure usually lasts not longer than 30 seconds. When seizure is over, child may not recall what just occurred. They just go on with activity as though nothing happened. So this seizure may occur several times a day. This type of seizure sometimes mistaken of learning behavior or behavior problem. Absence seizure almost always start between age of 4 to 12. Next, atonic seizure. This is also called drop attack. With an atonic seizure, child has a sudden loss of muscle tone and may fall from standing position and suddenly drop head. During the seizure, child will be limp and arm unresponsive. Then generalized tonic-clonic seizure, GTC. So this classic form of kind of seizure has four distinct phases. Child's body, arms, and leg will flex or contract and extend and shaking. This is followed by contraction and relaxation of the muscle and the postical period. During the postical period, child may be sleepy. He or she may have a problem with vision or speech and may have a fatigue. Last one is myoclonic seizure. This type of seizure causes quick movement of sudden jerking of a group muscle. This seizure tend to occur in cluster. This means that they may occur several times a day or several days in a row. So we go for emergency treatment of seizure. First, parents must remain calm. Time seizure episode. Protect child during seizure. Do not attempt to restrain child. Use force. If child is standing or sitting in chair at the beginning of attack, ease child down so that he or she will not fall. When possible, place a cushion or blanket under the child. Do not put anything in child mouth, loosen restrictive clothing. Prevent child from hitting hard or sharp objects that might cause injury during uncontrolled movements. Remove object. Move furniture out of the way. Allow seizure to end without interference. So when the seizure stops, check for breathing. If not present, use mouth to mouth. Keep child on his or her side. Check mouth, head or body possible injuries. Check around mouth for evidence of burn or suspicious substance that might indicate poisoning. Remain with child. Lastly, seek help if the child is not breathing. So, this is the highlight of epilepsy and seizure in children. A seizure occurs when one or more parts of the brain bursts of the abnormal electrical signal that interrupt normal signals. There are many types of seizure. Each can cause different kinds of symptoms. Epilepsy, when a person has two or more seizures with no known causes. Epilepsy is treated with medicine. In some cases, it may be treated with vagus nerve stimulation, VNS, or surgery. It is very important to avoid anything that triggers seizures.